Hello Photoshop users, this is a quick video to help you if you're stuck with the clone stamp tool. So your clone stamp tool is the icon that looks like a stamp. You can also get to it from your search bar in the top right, so you can search for clone stamp. Okay, you can also get to it by clicking S on your keyboard and it will activate the stamp. All right, so if you have these little pop-ups, tooltips always showing, you can always set to turn those off if you come into your file on a, actually settings on a Mac. I think it's called preferences on a PC. And you're going to come into Tools and Show Tooltips, which will automatically uncheck Rich Tooltips as well. And now you will not have those pop-ups. So if you do not need those pop-ups, you can turn those off. All right, so as any tool, when you select it, you then get additional options for it up across the top. The first thing you want to pay attention to is the size. So this is the same interface as your brush tool. And as you enlarge it, you will see the radius of your clone stamp change. Hardness, 100% is like a perfect circle. And as you change the hardness, as it becomes softer, you see it becomes almost like a radial gradient. All right, so we're going to do hardness 100%. And I've made my size enough that I could copy a balloon here. All right, so I have my clone stamp tool on and I click the balloon and it says could not use the clone stamp because the area to clone has not been defined. Option click to define a source point. All right, so the important thing is you need to define your source point. So I hold down option and I get this target. And what that says is this is the area I want to copy from. So I hold down option and I click, so that it knows this is where I want to copy. And now you can see it's actually carrying that pixel area with my clone stamp tool. So I can see where I am copying it to. And I can click once here and it has moved it. All right, so a few things to notice is one, this is a JPEG, it's from Pexels. And it is a flattened background. So I have just destructively changed this photo, right? This is not on its own layer. So this is not recommended. So if you have an image that you are cloning from, you're typically going to be working with multiple layers. So I've just duplicated that layer. So now I can lock my background again. And typically, I'm going to be working on a blank layer when I'm doing any kind of manipulating. And in this case, if I click my option, I've taken it from this area, and I try to paint, nothing is happening. Why? Right? So if you're using your clone tool and it doesn't seem to be working, you've remembered to click option, click. It is almost always this area here. So you're sampling from the current layer, which is a blank layer. So typically you want this to be current and below, or all layers, right? So I'm gonna choose all layers. This time, you can see if I select this area, it now copies that for me. And I'm on my blank layer. All right, so current and below, let's say I grab this one and I put it here. I'm still on this same layer. Now, one thing that you'll notice is that you can see it's not a smooth clone in this scenario. So I have a couple options. Is one, I could change my hardness so that it's really nice and soft. I could come in here and try again, and that's a much softer blend, right? So that might be changing the hardness of your clone stamp tool. Another option is to add a layer mask. So that's, it looks like our piece of paper with a circle in it. So this is white. And if I change to black, Now this is going to hide, right? And I can come in and I can paint to blend it. Again, I can change so I have a really soft brush, right? And I'm painting black around the edge of the sky so that it blends in more. So you can see that's just on my thumbnail. So again, quick tip, remember you can always click S to get to your stamp tool. You need to set where you're getting your, what you're copying from. That's gonna be an option click on your screen. You wanna make sure that your sample is set to the way that you want. Current and below or all layers is good. And then you would make sure that you are not destructing your image. So a non-destructive method would be a new layer. You can plop it down. And the reason why we can't see it right here is I painted that on my thumbnail instead of on my image. So there we go. All right, so I hope this helps you as you learn the clone stamp tool.